G sharp and A flat are not the same note. There, I said it. Now, for those of you who watch the enharmonic equivalents video, or those who just know what enharmonic equivalents are, or for those of you who went over to your piano and saw that G sharp and A flat are only one note, let me explain. Today we use a tuning system called equal temperament. This is a system that evenly divides the octave into 12 half steps, and those half steps are equally spaced. The octave can be divided into 1200 cents, with 100 cents for each half step. For reference, a quarter tone is 50 cents. We'll talk more about equal temperament later, but I wanted to go ahead and introduce the concept of cents right here. Now, over the millennia, we've tried out a bunch of different tuning systems, so let's talk about them. We've established that the octave is 2-1 and that the perfect fifth is 3-2. We all pretty much universally agree that we like those two intervals to be in tune. We also know from the circle of fifths that if we keep going up a perfect fifth, we end up in the same place eventually. So what if we had a tuning system where we just kept multiplying by 3/2? We call this Pythagorean tuning. To derive Pythagorean tuning, we'll pick a note, say D natural. We'll stick that one directly in the center. From there, we'll multiply 3/2 six times above, and we'll divide by 3/2 six times below, which, as you can see from the circle of fifths, we've used up all of our notes. Now, theoretically from there, we should be able to divide 2-1 to find the octaves of each note. Sounds easy enough, right? Well, if we look at the numbers, we've run into some problems. As I've mentioned before, the simpler the ratio, the more perfect the interval. More complex ratio, more dissonant interval. You'll notice the further that we get away from the center note, the more complex the ratios get. By the time that we get to the major third, the ratio is 81-64. This means that the third degree of the scale is really sharp, and it makes major chords sound out of tune. But there is another problem, and perhaps it's the largest problem with Pythagorean tuning. Let's construct this in a different way. Let's start with the D natural on the bottom. Now we'll multiply by 3-2 12 times. And what we would expect is that we would end up at the same D natural, just a couple octaves above. The problem is, when we do that, we end up 24 cents flat. We call this discrepancy the Pythagorean comma. This Pythagorean comma means that the last fifth is no longer perfect. We call it a wolf fifth, because it's so out of tune it seems to be howling. This is a large part of the reason that this system is no longer used. However, you'll notice in this system there is a distinction between the augmented fourth and the diminished fifth, both of which we would call a tritone. Okay, so if Pythagorean tuning doesn't work, let's just try another system. This next one is called just intonation. The goal of this system is to purely tune our major thirds, which was a major pitfall of Pythagorean. Another advantage of this system is that we're only going to use nice and neat small ratios. That makes for easy math. Why? Because we're going to fix the problem of the Pythagorean comma. Let's take the Pythagorean major third, which we said was much too wide and made it dissonant. This is a ratio of 81-64. Now, if we multiply 81-64 by the Pythagorean commas ratio, which is 81-80, we get 5-4. Wow, what an improvement. What this means is that the just intonation system perfectly correlates with the harmonic series, which gives us a beautiful, glorious scale in exactly one key. In just intonation, we derive the scale by multiplying by 5-4 to make sure that all of our major thirds are perfectly in tune. So, if we were to start from this C and multiply 5-4, we would get this E natural. And then another 5-4, which would give us G sharp. And from there, we can derive all of the rest of the chromatic pitches. But again, there's a problem. If we start at a C with a frequency of 261, and then we multiply 5-4, we get an E natural with a frequency of 326.25. However, if we start at the same C and multiply 3-2 until we get around to E natural and then divide so that those two E's are in the same octave, whoops, we end up with 330 hertz, a difference of 22 cents. We call this difference the syntonic comma. A note of interest, the 2 cent difference between the 24 cent Pythagorean comma and the 22 cent syntonic comma is called the schisma. Now, to get to the point of the episode, that G sharp is two major thirds above C, an augmented fifth. 5-4 times 5-4. However, A flat is a minor sixth away from C. And as we can see from the harmonic series, the ratio for a minor sixth is 8-5. So if C is a frequency of 261, and we multiply 5-4 times 5-4, or 25 to 16, we find a G-sharp whose frequency is 407.8125. However, 261 multiplied by 8 to 5 gives us an A-flat whose frequency is 417.6. Which, in fact, mathematically shows that G-sharp and A-flat are not the same note. And in fact, some early pianos were specifically designed to deal with this problem. However, the major problem with just intonation is that we can't easily transition from one key to another. For example, for C major to be perfectly in tune, it means that A flat major won't be. And in fact, A flat major will be so far out of tune, it won't be pleasant to listen to. This is the reason that eventually G sharp and A flat became the same note. We dabbled with a few other tuning systems across the centuries, but eventually we settled on equal temperament, and more specifically, a 12-tone equal temperament. Which, by the way, the well-temperament system that Bach made famous in his well-tempered clavier is not equal temperament. In equal temperament, what we decided to do is make every half step exactly the same distance apart. Essentially what it does is it knocks everything out of tune so that everything can be in tune. Makes sense, right? Instead of using simplistic ratios, we use the 12th root of 2. But despite the complex math, it does what we want it to do. It makes all of the half steps equally distant, and it keeps the octaves mostly in tune. However, it comes with a price. All of the other intervals are now out of tune. Fifths are 2 cents flat. Fourths are 2 cents sharp. Major thirds are 14 cents sharp. But our ears are okay with this because the difference is so small, it's difficult to discern. When we did this, G sharp and A flat became the same note, as did C sharp and D flat. It took us down to exactly 12 notes, which is why we call it 12-tone equal temperament. So is equal temperament good, bad, or should we say it is what it is? Of course, the fact that we can play in all of the keys without having to retune is a definite plus. However, some theorists believe that it's killed harmony altogether, taking hundreds of flavors of consonants and dissonants and making them all vanilla. However you feel about it, it certainly dominated Western music for the last couple of centuries. How do you feel about it? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching this episode of 2-Minute Music Theory. If you like what you saw, please like and subscribe. Also be sure to check out my other channel, Jesse Strickland Music, which is home of all of my compositions. And if you're the kind of person who uses social media, feel free to connect with me there.